Firstly, I'd like to wish a very special Merry Christmas to Sarah, Paige and Madison, three adorable angels. And for all those viewers out there, on behalf of the team and myself, we wish you a very safe and prosperous Happy New Year. Please be careful, enjoy your families, enjoy your lives, and take care over this festive season. And please enjoy the rest of the show. I'm Charles Dubois. Merry Christmas. Dream Universal, in association with One World Records, presents a Dream Team reality TV production. If We Can Dream will unite two entrants from each of 200 different countries who will be chosen to travel to Prague in September 2010 to participate in highlighting the urgent need for world peace.
I have a dream.
One World. One dream, one song, and one TV show. Follow us on our journey as we show you how we will make this dream come a reality. Log on to www.ifwecandream.com to join the Dream Team. Hi, I'm Charles Dubois. I hope you've been watching our show, If We Can Dream TV. Welcome to episode 3. Today, we're going to show you a sneak preview of my song, If We Can Dream, the official international world peace theme song and the humanitarian anthem. I hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
Must be lights burning brighter somewhere. Got to be birds flying higher in a sky more blue. If we can dream of a better land where all our brothers walk hand in hand, tell us why.
Welcome to On the Beat with Monique. Today we've been talking about prejudice and equality.
Martin Luther King, that whole thing in the US with the black civil with the civil rights campaign, and probably the apartheid in South Africa.
I think it's such a complex issue because, like, you've got wars going on for certain reasons at the moment, and like such different ideals in each different country that it'd be hard to get everyone to unite.
It means everything to me. It's being a girl, being gay.
For us, like voting, oh yeah, big whoop, eh? But for someone else, it'd be like over the moon. They'd be over the moon about the having the opportunity to do that.
Pyramids.
Beautiful.
Pyramids.
Pyramids.
Cars.
Beer.
I don't know, those hats.
Cold.
We shouldn't have the think about the colors, white or black, or the religions.
And back to the office.
This week we're launching our international campaigns now. We're not really going for the big organisations. We want to stick with the little guys, look after them.
Someone will tell me that they need a drawing or a piece of artwork done, and I do it as fast as I can.
Well, since I'm getting involved with the project, I'm being translating the website into Spanish and trying to make good contacts in Latin America and also in Brazil in all the Spanish and Portuguese countries.
We really need to promote the world peace situation and the communication between the countries so it actually works.
I think it's a great way to get people on board and to promote a great product that is going to help the world in any way it can through, you know, the five different charities that they choose to donate to.
We have to do something. If we have the power to do something, we have the voice, we have the ways to do it. We cannot just stay and look at what's going on in the world.
So it's going to be the largest multicultural shoot, officially.
If We Can Dream Universal, in association with One World Records, presents a Dream Team reality TV production. If We Can Dream will unite two entrants from each of 200 different countries who will be chosen to travel to Prague in September 2010 to participate in highlighting the urgent need for world peace.
I have a dream.
One world, one dream, one song, and one TV show. Follow us on our journey as we show you how we will make this dream come a reality. Log on to www.ifwecandream.com to join the Dream Team.
Not all families have the chance to wake up to holiday joy, a chance to be with one another, or a reason to celebrate. For as little as $3.50 this holiday season, you can help those in need.
Negative feedback from anyone?
I get people telling me that they don't see why they should bother entering the competition when if it's a randomly selected, like what's the point? You know, they're saying what's the point when there's 500 million people living in our country? What's the point of actually going in when it's randomly selected?
So how do you suggest that you be?
Well, they should, you know, describe to us in 20 words or less why they should, which would give them the feeling like they have a better opportunity to actually win the competition.
Well, listen, I think the executive producer is on his way here soon, so you guys are going to have to give him an update on what's going on. I think Kerry's here. So, hi, mate.
How are we all?
Kerry!
What's happening,
right? Oh, the public relations team has been focusing more on setting up our localised social media, which is a fairly lengthy task.
Sure.
Now, with that team working there, they're going to be bolstered up with another three members on Monday.
Oh, that's
good. Alrighty. And then they'll be focusing on just pushing that social media, you know, telling the people that they've got, you know, 450, you know, opportunities to be able to go to Prague and to ask people to tell us why we should choose them.
Well, we're getting the right people. Yeah, that's an important issue, isn't it? As to why they should be selected, what chance they've got, and what they can do to improve their chances.
Mm. Yep.
I think that's what we've got to focus on.